Greetings, Kenyans. 5 years ago, Mr. Kiraitu Murungi, then the senator of Meru, approached me in parliament buildings. He requested to have a tete-a-tete with me in regard to development issues in Meru County. I agreed to his meeting and we earned a lengthy discussion on how, as Meru senator, he felt that the county was not going to the right directions. He therefore requested me to help him spearhead message of all the people of Meru by putting the then county government on check. Mr. Kiraitu further requested me to talk to my then colleagues in the National Assembly so as to have a united front in a pursuit of accountable government in the county of Meru. I held a meeting with all members of parliament from Meru, and we were able to bring together our people, and that is how we were able to support Kiraitu bid for governor during 2017 elections. At that time, he had humbled himself so much and committed to serving the people of Meru directly, equitably, and in a transparent manner. He assured us of a Mandela moment if he would be elected the governor of Meru, saying that since he was honed, he wanted to serve his community well and exit the stage with his end eye. Being a person who loves development in Meru, I fully supported this idea and put it all the effort into campaigning for Kiraitu until I ensure he was elected the governor of Meru. Immediately after assuming the office, the governor formed a cabal from his clan which seamlessly sidelined all other people of Meru and started running the county as their private property. The first area to be hit and by its self-reliance and the green day was iron of staff where Governor Kiraitu recruited people from his clan to take the plump jobs in the county government while leaving out people from other regions of the Meru. He went ahead to sack all the employees who were serving in senior positions and the former regime just to create vacancies for his cronies. On saying this, I was highly disturbed because it negated the promise he had made to us during the campaign that he was run a government that reflects the face of Meru and accord equal opportunities to all people irrespective of their background. I tried to talk to him about it, but he dismissed me and went ahead to suffocate the county administration with the people from his Abogata clan. After 1 year of serving Kiraitu, diverting leaderships at the helm of our county, I decided to go out in public and tell the people of Meru that the regime was assisted to get to power was no longer serving the interests of the public. I announced that I would no longer support an administration that was misusing public funds where our people lack basic amenities such as medicines in hospitals and the water in the various regions of our county. I have given this brief history so that people can understand where we were coming from. Yesterday, Kiraitu Murungi, through his lawyer, wrote a letter to me alleging that I have defamed him on their FM and also public rallies. The letter continues to say that I have referred to Governor Kiraitu as a thief and a person who was engaged in several scandals in our country. He threatened to sue me and their FM for damages if I do not issue an apology within 7 days. It is in a view of this that I want to issue this statement. First, Kiraitu hired a war council that is fully paid by the county government, Omero, demean, insult and write all manner of things on social media and all and on other platforms of concerning me. His own staff, who are public officers, spend most of their time on a Facebook and a WhatsApp platform insulting me and posting unprintable against me. But Kiraitu has never seen this as wrong or even asked them to respect me, not only as a person who ensured he was elected so as to give them jobs, those jobs, but also a respected leader in Kenya.